Turned off the heat under the saucepan. He must leave plenty of time for it to cool down. When all the steam and the froth had gone away, he peered into the giant pan to see what colour the great medicine was. It was now a deep and brilliant blue. "Needs more brown in it," George said. "It simply must be brown or she'll get suspicious." George ran outside and dashed into his father's tool shed where all the paints were kept. There was a row of cans on the shelf, all colours, black, green, red, pink and white and brown. He reached for the can of brown. The label simply said, "Dark brown, gloss paint, 1 quart. He took a screwdriver and prized off the lid. The can was 3/4 full. He rushed it back to the kitchen. He poured the whole lot into the saucepan. The saucepan was now full to the brim. Very gently, George stirred the paint into the mixture with the long wooden spoon. Aha! It was turning brown. A lovely, rich, creamy brown. "Where's my medicine, boy?" came the voice from the living room. "You're forgetting about me. You're doing it on purpose. I shall tell your mother." "I'm not forgetting about you, Grandma," George called back. "I'm thinking about you all the time." "But there are still 10 minutes to go." "You're a nasty little maggot," the voice screeched back. "You're a lazy, disobedient little worm and you're growing too fast." George fetched the bottle of Grandma's real medicine from the sideboard. He took out the cork and tipped it all down the sink. Then he filled the bottle with his own magic mixture by dipping a small jug into the saucepan and using it as a pourer. He replaced the cork. Had it cooled down enough yet? Not quite. He held the bottle under the cold tap for a couple of minutes. The label came off in the wet, but that didn't matter. He dried the bottle with a dishcloth. All was now ready. This was it. The great moment had arrived. "Medicine time, Grandma," he called out.
"Oh, I should hope so too,"
came the grumpy reply. The silver tablespoon in which the medicine was always given lay ready on the kitchen sideboard. George picked it up, holding the spoon in one hand and the bottle in the other. He advanced to the sitting room.